He can actually really, really, really dance too, so. Hello everybody, how are you? How's it going? Friday afternoon and all. Everybody's awake, let's see. Oh, is there something that guy in the back? He's not awake. There's much. Did the back just warm you guys up? Did he get y'all excited or done?
I don't know, Magnus,
that wasn't the biggest. You guys were doing so well, just
Actually, in my defense, I was a little bit, when I just went backstage and saw the both of you in real life, I got a little bit, so, you know, these things happen. But, well, give it another shot, everybody, come on.
Remember, except for Paula, but she's the biggest fan of the bar, so that's okay. We just got here yesterday.
You got here yesterday. I've been on the ground for about 6 hours now. So, yeah. I flew all the way from New York. Boy, are my arms tired.
I, of course, don't. I'm not going to touch that one. Yeah, but he was already in the gym this morning. I forgot. So you're doing amazing. Good for you.
Don't tell them what I was doing in the gym, though. It was mostly just laying on the mat.
He was working hard. I got in yesterday morning. It's not my first trip to Sydney, though. I've been here. I was here in 1990. And I was 20-something at the time.
He's 26 now, which is amazing.
Exactly. So I've come back in time. I love it here. I'm fortunate enough to have my son here with me somewhere running around. His cousin, so we're very excited to be here in the land of Jail and that.
It's my first trip ever.
And I like it so far.
I think I'm gonna like it a lot by the end of this weekend. My poor wife is back in New York right now and she's cursing my name because she's never been either and she's just wrecked that she can't be here. I'm gonna try to make her jealous as much as possible this weekend. That'll probably be good for me, right?
Is there a hashtag we should be using to get that jealousy rolling in?
Hashtag please don't hate me forever.
Hashtag don't hate me.
Hashtag don't change the locks.
Well, are you guys happy? Should we just run right on into your questions?
Yeah, let's open it up there.
I can't believe that they're really here. But yeah, you know how it goes. Quick hand, but I'll come around. Look, this.
Hello there. What is your name and your voice, sir?
Steven. My question's to Dean. Obviously, it's my question, but I want to go back to the 90s days where you played in front of a boyfriend.
When I was even younger.
Yes. What was that experience like? Because it was quite a popular TV show at the time. And was it fun working with Shannon?
Well, at the time, it was probably the biggest, like, you know, young person show on television, and I was very excited. I grew up in and around the world of entertainment, though. A lot of the friends that I grew up with became very big actors, so I was used to that. And my dad was a director, and I grew up with Chris Penn, Sean Penn, Rob Lowe, Charlie Sheen. These are the kids that I grew up with. I watched them become famous as I was in college. So I wasn't, for me, it never was like, oh my gosh, I'm with famous folks, but the show was big, and the guys were very nice. They were all friendly. I knew it was a big deal when I got the part. Shannon was very nice. She's suffering from cancer now. I saw her recently. She's doing very well. But the best thing about that show when I was on it was I was working mostly with her. And, you know, you're the new kind of guy on the show. And you figure, are they going to be nice to me? The guy's going to be nice or whatever. And I hadn't seen Luke Perry at all on set because I wasn't working with him. And my character was kind of breaking up him and her or whatever. When I showed up, he saw me across from me. He goes, hey. Here it comes. And he came up and said, hey, Luke, really nice to meet you. I love what you're on the show. Thanks so much for being here. So I was like, what a nice guy. Nice. And then Jason Priestley did the exact same thing. And I learned something there on that show because you're this new actor on their show. And you go, okay, you know, I hope, you know, they're nice to me or whatever. And then they make me feel at home. And they really did. And that's something I've done every single time I've ever had my show. Anybody comes on. As a guest actor, I go up and I thank them for being there and I speak to them and try to make them as comfortable as possible. I learned that from those guys. It was a great lesson. It was a lot of fun to do the show.
Yeah, cheers. Thank you.
Wayne, Ian has another question.
What's the thing? He's got a thing. Is that, yeah.
I've seen quite a bit of your work. I've watched it since and I've been there. One of my favourites would have to be when you're on Britney's Believe It or Not. What was it like working on that set?
Well, Britney's Believe It or Not was I produced that show. My company made the show as well. And if anybody ever tells me they like Britney's Believe It or Not, that tells me a lot about them. Because it means you like the strange and the unusual. I appreciate about that. The end of that about you, sir. I appreciate that much. I enjoyed doing the show. It was a lot of fun. It was educational, and I liked all the weird things that were on the show. I was a history major in college, and I loved the historical artifacts we had. One of the derringers that John Wilkes Booth had on him when he assassinated President Lincoln actually says his name on the derringer. It's unbelievable. He jumped off. He shot the president. Jumped off on the stage, broke his leg, and dropped his back up there. I had that in my hand.
This is the second time that John Wilkes Booth has come up in conversation for me today.
He said, maybe you should play him. He'd be good.
Okay. is it the homicidal aspect of my personality? Or is it?
I wasn't in the gym, I'm thinking, yeah. You're killing in the gym. So it was that kind of stuff that I loved so much. And the medical miracles were great, and I really enjoyed doing the show. I like to host that show just like I was an audience member, and I was interested in what was going on, like everybody else was discovering at the same time. So I really enjoyed doing that show. We went for 4 years. I wish we'd gone for 40, which would be more. I'm not over 40 at this point in time. So I wish we were still doing the show. It was great for me, and I appreciate you watching. Thank you.
I have to mind my ear with. Let's see the lady in this room.
First of all, my costume was just tights. I didn't really have I can say Henry Cavill's got a great costume. I mean, I love the color. He's confused with the knickers, though. He's a little confused with the underwear. He's supposed to have them on the outside, but he didn't get that memo. Truly, you know who looks unbelievable in the suit is Supergirl herself. She's a Benoist writer. She's fantastic. And her suit is, like, in person, sometimes you'll see the suit in person or someone's suit. Ooh, not so great. Mine was just tight and whatever. I saw hers. She was, I'd seen her sort of in the suit and whatever, and I was like, that's kind of cool. And then we're shooting late one night, and she comes walking down. It's Vancouver, it was cold, it was like misty, and she's back lit, and she's in the suit. I was like, oh my gosh, look at that suit. It's incredible. It was like iconic. And then you look at it up close, she's got little shoulders in there. And it's so much better. So is it wrong for me to say I want to wear her suit? All right, a male version of her suit, which I guess you can tie her hat on. I haven't seen his version yet. Is it good? Is that good? All right. That sounds like a young yes. It doesn't sound like a young yes. I'd like to see that version. But they're getting cooler and they're getting better. She has the greatest cape, though. My cape is like wool. Hers is this reverie coolness.
It's crazy. It's just, she doesn't even need to be in wind or anything.
Nothing. We had a thing called an air mover. They would just shoot this huge megaphone looking thing at me, which of course they would point it up and the bottom of it would suck up wind from the ground. Which of course has little pebbles on it too, so like the first 7 seconds was just getting shot with stuff. And then I pretend I was fine.
Sitting next to a trash pile and just like, wow,
just doing on purpose. Sitting there throwing things at there, you know. Yeah, it's just a great trip. Sometimes when she flies, it's digitized.
I did not say that. I did not say that. They use special effects in TV.
No, they
no.
Not a thing in helmet.
A little bit more expensive, isn't it?
That's a matter of fact.
What I did here.
That's a pretty good question.
Hi, Dean.
Hello.
I used to love watching the dogs in the park, and then watching the new Supergirl with my son. And like, oh my god, that guy, that's your dad! That's super good in this series! I watched when I was really about your age. So, what's it like for you being Superman, but having dad of Supergirl?
It's great fun. I have always embraced being a part of that universe. I think it's a great thing. A lot of times an actor will play a role and it's iconic. The roles are iconic and you call them by the character name. I have no problem with that. We do it. We'll do it to ourselves. Other actors will do it. They'll be like, oh, there goes, you know, Joey from Friends. We know his name is Matt LeBlanc. There's Joey. You just do it. It just happens, or whatever the name of the character happens to be. And it's fun. So you know, people have called me a lot worse things than Superman, so I'll take that. I'm okay with that. And it's great to be part of the world. You know, Terry Hatcher just played a number of episodes as well. Helen, who plays my wife, was the original Supergirl. Andrew, our exec producer, does a great job of bringing in a lot of faces from that universe, and it's great fun. I mean, it's a little weird to not be doing the super things. But I did an episode of Smallville as well. I got to watch Tom Welling run around and do things and be super. And I wasn't the super guy. I'll tell one quick Tom Welling story, okay? Can I do that? We were doing a scene where he has to sort of super speed through the scene, but we were setting it up and all the rest of us had to kind of move slowly and he would go through fast and go super speed. And then we were rehearsing it, he was like, shh. We don't make sound effects. That's not what we do. But he was like,
having a gun and being like, bang, 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 bang,
bang. What you have to do, by the way, in rehearsals, you have to go bang, bang, bang. It's not good to do it during the take. So that was a lot of fun. But I'll embrace it. Yeah, look, I played the guy, now the dad. I'll do it like the grandpa. I'm good with it. Which is like 2 years ago.
Okay. We have a question from Finn here, who just, by the way, is looking spectacular.
Is that a level of lions? I can't see him here.
Oh. He's a young fella.
He's a millennial falcon?
He's like a millennial falcon.
Outstanding. It's the Falcon shirt.
Vin, what is your question?
Hey guys, this is a question for both of you. Since you're both in the DC kind of realm, what are your general thoughts on 100 since its release?
She's easy on the eyes. State the obvious right now.
Truthfully, I haven't seen it yet. I know that's...
He's busy. He works for a living. I don't, so...
I'd say I read this great article about how they assembled the whole team of Wonder Woman's Amazonian battle cohorts. They went after the coolest, most badass women to surround her with. I mean, it was awesome. They had CrossFit athletes. They recruited track stars and volleyball stars. They got it right. They got the badass strength of these women right, I think. And it's really cool to see.
I did see the film, and I agree with that 100%. Here's the thing about a lot of the films these days. Now, you look at the original Star Wars, and we were just having this conversation a little bit ago, and the original Star Wars, the special effects weren't so fantastic, but the story was amazing. And some of these films, sometimes, in my opinion, get a little bit lost in the special effects. Wonder Woman has it's a pretty long movie, and to be honest, here's what happened. Because suddenly I went to see Guardians of the Galaxy Part 2. We enjoyed that, it was fun. There were a lot, I think, a little too much special effects in that one. The first one I loved a little bit more. We saw that, then we were walking out, and then there was this woman staring at me as I was walking out of the theater. It was Gal Gadot on the poster.
Infinitely less interesting.
But she spoke to me. She said, Dean, there was a movie right now. At least that's what I thought she said. So I was suddenly, I went and watched the second movie in a row, and that was Wonder Woman. And it was unbelievable. Maybe it seemed long because we've been in the theater for 7 hours by the end. It was a good film. And the DC, Marvel's been kicking our tail in the movie world for a while now. We own television for the most part, but Marvel's been kind of kicking our tail. And I think this is a good step up. I think Wonder Woman is a very good step up. There will be a second one, for sure. I'm quite certain. Like I said, I'll watch Gal Gadot drink a cup of tea for 3 hours. Honestly, so I'm watching the second one.
You can, actually. That's your next film.
That's good.
Gal drinks tea.
We have a question from Reese here. Reese
says this is to deprive people the thrill of looking at you. Here we go.
Hey, Colin, it's a question for you in regards to... I wanted to know, when it comes to you acting in Arrow, when it comes to you doing Chicago Med, it's completely different types of film, like TV. How do you travel when it comes with being a business person in Arrow to being a medic and a doctor in Chicago Med? How do you tackle those two roles?
I'll echo what Dean says. I mean, it starts with everything that's on the page. Luckily we shared a producer with Andrew Pressburg,
Arrow.
Yeah, and so, when Andrew and Mark created Arrow, they wrote some really, really wonderful stuff, and we have also amazing creators on Chicago Med, so it's pretty easy, I shouldn't say it's easy, it's once you slip on the costume and you get in front of the cameras and you've got great people that you're surrounded with, it's what we do, I guess. I mean, you play a bad boy businessman like Tommy, and then go be a cocaine sniffing, maybe rapist in the affair, and then be a rapist, and then go and be a doctor all of a sudden. It's cool. I mean, that's really the joy, I think, of continuing to work is to stretch in different directions. I just haven't lost my career yet.
I got a good question for you. Because I haven't done a medical thing yet. How difficult is it to come up with all the medical jargon?
There's a lot of good outtakes. we've been begging them to put together some sort of gag reel. Because I'll tell you a quick story. The first day of shooting for Chicago Med, we did this big scene on the L train in Chicago. And we were actually on the train, on a moving, working train, and it's supposed to crash off the tracks. And terrible stuff. Then, cut to later on in the day, we came inside to our hospital set, and I was in like full hero mode, standing on the gurney, doing compressions on a guy as he's bleeding out all over the place, like covered in blood, and I just have a string of medical dialogue. And it's the first time that I'm having to go and say these big long words.
So say one of them.
Yeah, so I'm like shouting all this information out as I'm standing on the gurney and doing compressions. Now, I don't know if anybody's been taught how to do compressions,
yeah,
but you're supposed to stay alive while you're doing it, because that's the
right beat,
the rate of speed. Which is, so
you can sing, so that's good.
They yell action, and all like I'm standing up there, and all I can think is extension of my language, but complete halt. It was terrible. I got halfway through the scene and went, do over, please. That's the beautiful part about CP. You can take two. Sometimes take 15.
You should have stayed with Stay Alive, just gone through it. Just hovering.
Story
Hard to say what happens. We also lost to Jimmy Olsen, and things happen, and that happens within any, sometimes it's like what Collin said before, life gets in the way, something happens. Sometimes it's a contract negotiation, sometimes, who knows. I'm not proving why she didn't return the second season. See, she was a sexy character. The sexy season, I mean, I don't know if the case was 100%. Just same as I didn't know why it would change Jimmy Olsen 100%. And that stuff just happens sometimes. But Tracy Scoggins is who played Kat. Unbelievable that she was an absolute firecracker. She was way more brave than I'll ever be. And she might have climbed the Warner Brothers water tower. I might have gone halfway up and froze. Allegedly. And climbed back down.
Thank God that Twitter didn't exist back
then. Oh my, thank God Twitter didn't exist through my college life too. I just want to throw it out there to all of you who have to grow up in this age of social media. Tough. You super kids, you'll learn what I'm talking about.
Sand in the literature.
Hey, my name is Adam, questions for you, Nate. I think it was in one of the special pages that I was on the plot, David, where you said you once had a 20 to survive a shit day. And I assume you're a member of a union that says you can only work so many hours and have to make a certain amount of hours between each shit day. So I was curious how much it gets away from doing the 20 to a shit day and what's the life of the do good work when you're working that long.
22 hours. Yep, we did. They had to get permission. They got to pay through the nose, especially the crew. A lot of the actors, you know, getting paid per episode. There's not really I can't remember the last time I got paid extra money for working past 12 hours. I'm not sure I ever have. It becomes a team effort. You got to get things done. Sometimes that's a real bad idea because people are getting so tired. They also have to drive home. There's so many problems with that. We needed to get the show done. You know, that's really what it came down to. So we got behind, and who you can point fingers at a number of people, but at a certain point, you just got to get things shot, you got to get things done. And we had to get that done. I don't recommend it. It's horrible. It's not safe. And fortunately, nobody got killed driving home or anything like that. But I think they've amended that a little bit to some degree. But I still love it. You know, I'm shooting Super, I'm watching those guys pull their hammers. They're 16 hours from the time they leave to the time they're home, and it's not a whole lot different in that regard. I thought about that as an actor, it's so tough. But on the crew, it's just ridiculously hard. And I wish there was a way we were only working 12 hours. That'd be great. Most people think of that, you know, a work day is like eight or 9 hours. We're scheduled at 12 every single day. It's not as glamorous as it always seems, I promise you. But it's, you get together, you work as a team, you get it done.
Julio, that's a question.
Graham! This guy, I love this guy. Welcome to Australia. Thank you, Graham. It's a pleasure to be here, sir.
Yeah. And another close encounter. Listen, my question is that you and Terry, in my books, were the best Lois and Clark on the TV. It was really great to see. Is there any chance of seeing you and that lovely lady do another show together?
Well, it's a good question, sir. Graham came all the way across to America in one of these compounds. I met him. He's amazing. Former Australian soldier, by the way, so much respect to you, sir. It's been interesting. There's been a lot of shows that have done sort of reboots, if you will. And you know, whether it's Will and Grace or whoever, getting together to finish off a season or shoot it, a film, a 2-hour movie or something. Well, Lois and Clark, we ended our season 4. We were picked up for season 5. We were getting prepared to shoot season 5, and then Terry got pregnant. You guys know that happens, right? I don't have to know. So that happened, and she couldn't work. So she couldn't work. We were canceled between season 4 and 5 after being picked up. So we had a whole storyline that we weren't actually aware of at the time. So we never got to finish it. And since there's been a lot of reboots lately, it's gotten some traction that might be something that would happen.